We are always tremendously honored to have them in the room. They were just here in December. We're making it a quarter year residency, if we can. This gentleman who's gonna get us started tonight, we are thrilled to have here. I've been seeing him all over town and waiting for our chance to have him in the room, and we are delighted to tonight. Please make welcome Matt Andersen.
Thanks very much. I'm looking forward to some of these intimate moments we're all gonna share. I think that's gonna be great.
Thank you. about your name. Oh, if a love like this is poison, I'll just live my life in pain.
Chasing my girlfriend around wherever she got a job, I'd follow her. Didn't really matter where I lived as long as there was an airport. So. But one of our last moves, after we got settled in, she asked me if I was okay with the move or if I wanted to live someplace else. And at a very brief and very rare moment of brilliance, I said, "I don't care wherever you live as long as I'm with you." I mean, really, that was pretty good, I thought. But as it turns out, the whole duration of our relationship, that's the only time I ever said the right thing at the right time, so figured we should write a song about it, and that's where this one came from.
You are my home. You are my home, sweet home. You're resting on my mind when I'm far away alone. You are my home, sweet home. Houses only brick and stones, four walls and a refuge from the cold. My body's only flesh and bones, till it's filled with love for someone else's soul. It's only brick and stone. You are my home. You are my home, sweet home. You're resting on my mind when I'm far away alone. You are my home, sweet home. Star I see, I'll follow where you lead. You are my home. You are my home, sweet home. You're resting on my mind when I'm far away alone. You are my home, sweet home. Harbor lights and endless nights and a wind that always blows. Turn me round, don't let me drown. Take me with you when you go.
You guys are so lucky to have this room. What a great spot. My first time here, and it's been great. This is the first tour of this year for me. Had a great time touring around last year. Probably the biggest tour I've ever done. Took a tour bus on the road, which is something I've never done before. Yeah, I learned all kinds of road skills I never knew I had. Special talents you develop on a bus. Like, I could tell who wasn't there by the smell that wasn't on the bus. That's something you learn. You weren't just born with that one, apparently. Learned a few things I didn't expect to learn. One thing I learned is that when you go to the UK and in Europe especially, their definition of a full-size vehicle is not our definition of a full-size vehicle. Something to keep in mind for you world travelers. Coast in Canada. I live in Nova Scotia. Yeah, you can clap for that. That's all right. I'm fine with that. This is like a vacation for me coming down here, really. There's no snow to shovel. It's fantastic. But I lived in Cape Breton for a while, which is an island just off of Nova Scotia. And coal mining is a big part of the history there. The works dried up. The idea of doing whatever you have to do to take care of your family is still there, and it's a job I have a lot of respect for, the guys who did that work. They inspired this tune. This one's called Coal Mining Blues. Thank you.
times that will come, when the walls cave in and the cold fills my lungs. Oh, if life is a blessing, please let it be. Someday God's light will give these poor souls relief. Black on my hands, black on my shoes, black on my heart for these You wake up in the morning, see the sun, sinking down. You wake up in the morning to see the sun sinking down. You see that man on the corner, wish he was shaving your frown. Do you ever go walking just to see how far you can go? You ever go walking just to see how far you can go? You turn around when you get just to stop walking right on back home, right on back home. When your love is lying right there next to you. few years ago back home, we lost some really great people in our musical family. We lost them all kind of too close together. And it got me thinking to myself one day, you know, what would I do if I knew it was going to be my last day on Earth? So I put the question out there to a bunch of my friends, and a lot of them got back saying they just get really drunk and have a big party, which didn't really surprise me much. But one guy said he'd keep driving for the West Coast because the day would be longer. I thought that was pretty clever. That's the idea behind this one. This one's called My Last Day. I knock on the door to see my mother. Thank her for raising me right. I pick up the phone and call my old lovers. Tell them there's no need to fight. What would I do? What would I do? Pockets. I wouldn't worry about the bills that I owe. I close that door, I'm not gonna lock it. 'Cause I've gotta go. I've gotta go. Bye bye, baby, so long. Turn out the lights on. for a couple more tunes with you. Thank you so much for having me here tonight. A big thanks to Los Lobos, too, for let me do these shows with them. It's pretty cool to be on the road with these guys. They're going to kick your ass all over the place here. Yeah, this tune is the title track off the newest album. This one's called Honest Man. Everybody, it's a real treat to be here with you. Hope you had some fun. If you didn't, you should have said something earlier. I've got some CDs over there. If you'd like one, go ahead and pick one up. I'll sign one for you after the show. And even if you don't want one, go ahead and pick one up. I'll still sign it for you. I'm going to finish off with a tune that I wrote about a couple from my hometown. Just about every Thursday night in my hometown, I play at our local pub, and just about every Thursday, this one couple would show up, and they sit at the same seats, get the same drinks, get really drunk, and get into a big fight, and they were our main source of entertainment. We take bets to see if they show up the next week or not. They always did. They were pretty reliable. And, anyway, this song's all about a guy who's in a relationship with a woman that he finds himself not wanting to be in a relationship with anymore, and no matter how hard he tries, he just can't get away from it, and ends up realizing the only fella she's fit for is the devil.
Nice bit of romance to wrap everything up with. And just in case you're here tonight with somebody you feel that way about, maybe just cuddle up halfway through the tune, and give their knee a little squeeze, and find yourself another ride home. Thank you so much, everybody. Enjoy the rest of the night. We'll see you next time. And broke a string just like that. It's okay, I've got more of them. It's pretty quick. This is the best part of the show, really. Not everybody gets to see this. This is a Lakewood guitar. They're from Germany. Actually, I've got just enough time to tell you a really good rock and roll story while I'm doing this. Last summer, we finished off our tour in the States, and we had 2 days left. And this, again, is one of those things I learned on the road. We had 2 days left, and I'd run out of clean underwear, and I thought, well, there's nothing to do. We've got to at least have clean underwear. You can get by with, you know, clean jeans and that kind of stuff, but clean underwear is a must. So I did my usual. I washed them in the tub and hung them up to dry just as a quick fix, but woke up in the morning and they hadn't dried yet. So I looked for a blow dryer, no blow dryer, not even an iron. So I went to the next available heat source, the microwave. And I thought, this should work. So I wrapped the first pair in a towel and I stuck them in there, and I pushed the popcorn button, and 3 minutes later, ding, a nice toasty pair of underwear. It worked out perfect. I thought, good job, Matt. You're brilliant. Future musicians are going to thank you. The young up-and-comers are going to be like, this guy, he taught us so much. What a legacy to leave behind. And so I threw the next pair in, pushed the popcorn button again. This one came out a little bit wet still, so I threw one again, started to brush my teeth, and I was hit with the smell of burning rubber. The rubber band, my underwear, had caught fire and burned a ring around the inside of the microwave, and smoke was pluming out, and all I could think was, they're going to put up a warning sign that says, don't microwave your underwear, and that's going to be my legacy. So just a little life lesson for you, a little rock and roll wisdom. 3 minutes is good. Anything more, just leave it alone. Walk away. Wear them dirty. Look at that. Change of string. Got a great story in. All just perfect. Look at that. Who'd you see last night? Los Lobos and some big guy who burns underwear. I don't know who it was. Let's try this one again. Down. ask you to do one more thing for me before we head out. Before I head out, anyway. I need you to imagine yourself a few years ago driving through the East Coast up in Canada. You're driving along the beautiful St. John River Valley. You come across this tiny town called Perth Andover. That's my hometown. Get your better reaction in my hometown, but that's all right. That's all right. That was a nice moment. That was good. Well, as you're driving through, you see a sign up on the telephone pole for some live music on Thursday nights. And it just happens to be a Thursday night, so you step inside and settle up to the bar, start chatting with the bartender for a little bit. But before too long, he's taken away to deal with somebody else. So with your drink in your hand, you just take a casual look around the room to see who's there and see what's going on. Your attention is drawn to this one couple off in the corner all by themselves. Looks like they're having a very intense conversation. You look at the woman and she's just kind of talking away, sipping on some kind of a drink that the locals call a Moscow Moose. What you find out is just a really big glass with a little bit of ice and a lot of vodka. Yeah. You look at the fella and he's just shaking his head. Staring down at 10 empty shot glasses. Well, you find yourself concentrating on this man for a few more minutes and you start to recognize this look coming across his face. It's the look of a man who's got something to say he's been wanting to say for an awfully long time. She has no idea it's coming. So like any good, polite person would do, you grab your drink and turn yourself around in your bar stool so that you can get a good look at all the action. And just as he stands up and he kicks back his chair and he throws down that last shot of whiskey, the whole room goes quiet. This is what everybody hears him say.
Anderson. As you may have mentioned, there's some merchandise for sale on the left of the stage underneath our merch man, Bob Dylan. Head on over there, check out some of the wares for sale, grab yourself another drink, because the Mighty Los Lobos is coming up next.